Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to the segment Jewels of Inspiration. My name is Murshida Sayed, international speaker, entrepreneur, corporate trainer, spreading the message of love and respect. This segment is produced by Ahmad Nazri Muhammad Yusuf. Now, we have been talking a lot on positivity and the importance of having a positive mind. So, today, I will address some tips on how to be positive in minutes. I love this verse in the Quran, which always gives me a sense of hope and positivity. In Surah Al-Insyirah, so verily, with hardship, there is relief. Verily, with a hardship, there is relief. Quran, chapter 94, verse 5-6. We know having a positive mindset is important, and I still have many people asking me, Madam Murshida, how can I be positive? Look at my family situation, look at my workplace, everything is so negative. How can I be positive? Now, to always be positive, our mind has to be focused on working on positivity. Our mind has a direct link with our heart. When our heart has love, that's when the mind becomes positive. A heart needs to have love channeling out as well as channeling in. That means you are giving out love and you are receiving love. Now, here are some techniques that you can use immediately to have positivity in your mindsets. In minutes. Okay, I would like you to first divide your life in three parts, depending on your age. What is your age? See, if you are 30 years old, you divide it by three. So from 0 to 10, 10 to 20, and 20 to 30 years old. Write down all the things that you have accomplished in your lives from the first part of your life, which is from 0 to 10. And all the things that you have accomplished in your life from 10 to 20, and all the positive things that you feel very happy about from 20 to 30. This is your third part. And start to remember all the good things that you have accomplished in your lives. Look back and be very, very grateful. Look, you went through so many challenges in the past and you managed to overcome it. Perhaps it was a time when you had no money, but you managed to buy a house, or you face challenges and you manage to do something good out of that challenge. So when you reflect back at all the past that you have experienced that were successful, that was good, that was positive, you will start to attract all the good things back in your life, and your mind will start focusing on the positivity. Our mind focuses on what it sees repeatedly. So what you can also do in your surrounding is use positive imagery, visuals, pictures, posters surrounding you. Perhaps in your mobile phone, you can carry pictures that reminds you of love, pictures that remind you of good messages, quotes from the Quran, good motivational reminders, hadiths. You know, use all these imageries and visuals that are accessible, and when you look at them, you will feel positive and very grateful. Also, some of us are auditory people, so you can also start listening to good sounds, good reminders over the radio, from your phone, listening to good advice, listening to good sounds like Al-Quran. Play the Al-Quran reading in the house or have it recorded in your phone. And whenever you're feeling down or negative, just play the Ayat Quran and you will start to realign all your negative thoughts towards your purpose, towards your positivity. You know, some people like to listen to music. Yes, I would like to recommend, you know, you can always listen to good classical music, beautiful nasheed. Hey, listen to Ikim FM. That will put you in a positive mindset in minutes. Learn to use positive languaging instead of words like, I don't think I can, everything is so bad right now, I don't think it's possible. Change your languaging. Instead of using those negative words, use words like, I wonder how I can achieve so and so. I would love to have this in my life. Let me think of how I can achieve them. So just by rephrasing your words, you also rephrase your mindset. Using positive language changes your mindset towards positivity. Negative words leads to negative emotions and the feeling of negativity as well as helplessness. So learn to rephrase words. Phrase and rephrase words using positive languaging. This puts your psyche in a good state, a happier state, and a more positive state. Remember, you know the saying, what you focus on expands, what your mind focuses on, that is what your mind will think of. Okay? So do not think of a pink elephant. Don't think of a pink elephant. Or what does your mind think of? That pink elephant, right? So this is exactly how our mind works. What you focus on expands. So start focusing on things that you want in your life instead of focusing on things that you do not want in your life. Also, another thing on how you can change your mindset towards positivity immediately is through movement. Movement helps change your state. Say, for example, you are sitting down and then you get some bad news and you get into a negative state of mind. Change your state. If you're sitting down, stand up. Take a walk. Lie down. When you change your physical state, you will automatically change the state of your mind as well. Whatever position that you are in, when you are negative, change it. Take wudu. Solid. All these are immediate changes that you can do physically, and it will change your mindset towards positivity, and it will change your emotions as well towards a feeling of happiness and positivity. Also, you are highly recommended when you are facing negative emotions, take a walk. Research shows that taking a 10-minute walk puts you in a happier state of mind. So take a walk, breathe in, breathe out, take deep breaths, stay calm, make lots of ZK. And that is how you can put yourself in a positive mindset. The other thing that I love are smells. Do you know smells can actually affect your emotions? Imagine for some coffee drinkers, the smell of coffee puts them in a happier state of mind. The smell of certain flowers can also put you in a happier state of mind. And for some people, the smell of durians puts them in a very happy state of mind. I personally love to use essential oils. You can use nice scents like musk. Your favorite scent that triggers a happy memory. It can be a lavender scent. It can be a floral scent. Any scent that can switch your mindset towards a happy memory. This also works too. Now, taste also can affect your mindset. Can you imagine, for especially coffee drinkers, when you drink that first sip of coffee early in the morning and you feel happy and content, taste can also help to change your mindset towards positivity, affects your emotions. So whatever works for you, coffee or sweets, dark chocolate also has an effect of, putting you in a happier state. For tuna, let's take honey. Honey, when you make doa and you put it into your mouth, you will also automatically have a happier state of mind because honey is sweet. Kurma, dates are also sweet, and these are also healthy foods that you can take to immediately switch your mindset towards positivity. And they're also healthy, and they're also happy foods. So win, win, win. Everything is good, you know, win, 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 win. So take honey because it's healthy, it's delicious, it's sweet, and it puts you in a happy state. Another technique that I also like to use is think of a happy memory in your life. There's one incident in your life where you can remember and you feel really happy, you feel successful, you feel grateful. There was one incident. It can be a time when your mother kissed you on your cheek. It can be a time when your father says, I'm so proud of you. It can be a time where you achieved something that was difficult, but you made it. Be very clear in that memory. Remember the sight, the sounds, the smells. If you can, the temperature even. So that memory is very clear in your mind. And what you can do is you can imagine that memory going in from your mind and into your heart. And imagine that memory from your mind, it goes into your heart and it's coming out from you in a bright light. I call this the ball of love. You know, imagine this memory coming out from your heart and encompassing you like a ball. It's a bright light. You can choose any color, your favorite, your choice, that it comes out from your heart and it's in a shape of a ball and it's encompassing you. Imagine that happy, loving memory surrounding you and growing and growing, and it makes you feel very happy. And imagine that ball of love coming out from you and affecting the people near you positively. Visuals help to create positive aura. So you can have this visual in your mind and imagine it coming out from you and affecting the people around you. This is what I call the powerful ball of love. I have seen negative people transform in front of me just by me channeling this ball of love towards them. Another method I advocate also is keeping a gratitude journal, where you write all your happy memories and incidents and all the things that you are grateful for in your life. When you are grateful, your heart is filled with love and shukur. Your mind will be positive. In the Quran, Surah Ibrahim, chapter 14, verse 7, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are grateful, I will give you more. I really believe in this verse. There was a time in my life when I was always down and I was complaining. And then I was reading the Quran and this verse was right in front of me. If you are grateful, I will give you more. And that was a time when I felt really bad. And I started to say all the good things, all the gratitude that I have in my life for Allah. He has given me so much. We have so much to be grateful for. And when we start to be grateful, that is where you will see all your life challenges, all your small problems appear as they are. Very, very small. Another thing that you can work on is your smile. Start smiling. Look in the mirror. Smile the silliest grin, the biggest grin, and you will be amused. Give your biggest smile to people you meet. As you give salam, you spread peace and positivity. Say assalamu alaikum to the people around you and smile. And when you smile, it is also an act of giving. It is sadaqah. Making someone happy will make you happy. With that, I will make dua that you can always be positive within minutes or even seconds. Just let that gratitude and positivity flow within you. Let that zikir, all the positive thoughts, flow through your veins and in your minds and hearts always. I make dua that you are always happy and positive. This is Murshida Said wishing you, all of you, a life full of love and respect for the sake of your success in dunya and akhirat. Please go on, spread love and respect. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.